My name's Jo Dover, and I've been working with victims of terrorism since 1998. Most people would expect that if you've been affected by terrorism, your life is ruined, it's over. And I think what I've learned over the years is that many people, not only do they survive what happened, but they actually go on to do some amazing things. They don't just recover, they don't just build their resilience and go back to normal. Some people really go on to do something amazing with their experience. It's made them stronger. Really key thing for lots of people is to share their experiences and to work with other victims and make sure that people don't feel like they're a prisoner of their experience. In some countries, the governments really take it seriously, and particularly in the immediate aftermath. But over time, that kind of diminishes for people. And even here in New York after 9/11, I think people now would be thinking, well, it's 16 years on, what's the big deal, or aren't you better now? And I think that's a really key thing that most people I've worked with really struggle with, because actually these things stay with them forever. In terms of assistance, it's quite common for the authorities to provide things for the first couple of years, maybe some, in some cases longer. But for some people, they get on with their day-to-day lives, and actually it's later, much later, that they realise that they've been impacted. And at that point, most of the support is gone. So in terms of what the international community can do, I think is recognise that the victims exist, don't forget about them, make sure that the support is there as long as they need it. In terms of the victims and survivors themselves, my message would be, you're not alone with this. There are other people who understand, who know what you're going through, who can help, and you can actually make a really big difference in other people's lives as well as your own.